today we're going to install GloRyder wheel lights on our 2010 Camaro. They actually look like this. I got the upgraded ones that have the Chevy emblem in the center of it that's supposed to glow as well. So we already have the tire off. What we're going to do now is actually go through the process of putting the mounting kit on, and we'll show you what it looks like when it's finished. First thing we're going to do is we're going to pop out the center caps that are on our current wheels here, and just take a screwdriver or your finger, really, either one will actually work probably, and just pop it out. It's held on with little plastic brackets, and it comes right out. Next, we'll be adjusting our harness or our bracket from the back of the rim and installing this before we actually put the light assembly in the front. That's it. All right, we got the screws all adjusted to where we want, and we're gonna actually just insert this into the center of the back of the rim itself. The goal here is to make sure it's centered as much as possible. Put a little bit of slack in it so we can make some adjustments once we put the light housing on the front. Bracket that's on the inside, we're gonna put the screw through and actually put the light housing on. And we're just gonna line up and screw it down. And before we tighten everything, we're just going to make sure that it's completely centered. Now that we have the bracket on, we're just going to make sure that everything is centered correctly. And then we're just going to finish up by tightening these two big screws that hold the front housing on. And then afterwards, we're going to come back with a Allen key and just tighten these down a little bit snug. So in case anything does loosen up, it won't move around too much. Now that all the screws are tightened down and our housing is on the front and it's centered, we're going to put the tire back on the vehicle, and then we'll show you how to put the light assembly inside. Okay, the next step is we're going to install the electronics that go into the actual GloRyder housing itself. Two screws hold it in place. There's three batteries that have to go on these. So we're going to pop in the batteries. Here's the light sensor right here, which actually makes sure that it only comes on at night so you're not wasting your batteries during the day. These will automatically come on when the tire is in rotation, so when you're stopped for, I believe it's a minute and a half, they'll actually shut off to save the battery life on the car itself. This is a switch right here that you could turn them on or off or put them in show mode, and I don't know if you could really pick that up or not, but that is actually on right now. So we're just going to put them into glow mode. That's the one where the tire starts moving, it actually turns on. Now all you have to do is, these are the two mounting screws inside. There's one up on top and one on bottom. We're just going to line these up, rotate it a little bit to kind of lock it in place, and then we're just going to tighten those two screws down and tighten that on. Now we have it mounted inside, it's very secure. We're going to put our cap on. Please make sure that you have the setting that you want on now before you screw the cap on. It's going to take you some time to actually take it back off if you have it in the wrong setting. We're going to line up the screw holes on either side with the screw holes that are on the housing itself. Here's the little tiny screws. Just tighten them in there, but not too tight. We just want to get them in and snug. Once you have it all mounted on there, this is what it's actually going to look like. As you see, it blends right in with the tire. It's nothing big and bulky hanging off. I think when you see these on, you're actually going to be impressed with how much light it actually casts along the rim itself. So give me a couple and we'll show you what it looks like at night.